I have no answer for that, Reed, because I cannot understand why this industry is being overlooked. It is going to be definitely the front runner for kickstarting the economy, because of the wide range that we cover, the whole spectrum that we cover, the ripple effect that goes down so deep, and more than that, it's the feel-good factor that travel and tourism brings. And we're all very dejected right now, very down in the dumps. And the feel-good factor that will come up with this is something that it's for all to see. And I really don't understand why the government has not been able to recognize it. We had some very simple requests. I won't even say that they were demands. We were looking at a moratorium. But, you know, this morning, Shaktikant Das, the RBI governor, has extended the moratorium by another 3 months, which again, I think is a bit of a joke because, you know, the first 3 months are over and the lockdown is still there. And our industry is not going to get back anywhere close to normal for another year. So, but having said that, it's a bit of a respite. We did need some support like the support of all governments. For example, the UK is giving 80% of the salary. So there's been no job losses. People are on board. The hotels may be closed, but at least their jobs are intact. Here, the problem that is going to be faced by us, it is already being faced by us, and it's a very typical scenario in all hotels. Your biggest payout is your payroll, and post that is your bank, and then you get on to your operational and utilities. The payroll is becoming a huge issue for us, because there has been absolutely no generation of income whatsoever. We've got a few doctors here and there, but there's nothing really coming out of it. Now, how long can we sustain that payroll is a big question. We were looking for some support from the government, at least to give us some element, maybe not all, maybe 10%, 20%, 30%, whatever they could. It hasn't happened. Why has it not happened is really a very difficult question to answer, but perhaps there is a feeling that exists in policymakers that we are an elitist industry. You know, I mean, the hotels are all luxury and they're five star and they have a lot of money, so they can get, you know, they can cope up with this, which is not correct, because the luxury element of our hotels is very small. We go down to three star, two star, we go down to the roadside amenities, we go down to you know, bed and breakfast rooms. There's a whole range that exists. So it's not just the luxury segment. So clearly, I think they do need to realize it, and we are going to continue. We also need some support from the states, because there is, we have these payouts of mandatory payouts, statutory payments that we made, whether it's property tax, whether it's lease rentals, whether it's license payments. Now, when there is no business and we still have to continue paying those, it's irrational. So the states need to come up and support us as well. And so does the center. When is it going to happen is a big question mark, but we're not stopping. I think every single association has reached and knocked at every single door, and we will continue to do so, because this industry needs to survive. Because if it does not survive, it is really going to be a very, very negative effect on the economy of India. And on the other hand, if we do survive, we can definitely be the torchbearers of the revival of the Indian economy. I don't see why they should connect us. So, aviation is part of travel and tourism. There is no doubt about that. But I think what we were asking for was not a cash bailout.
Right.
We never did. That's why it becomes even more difficult for us to comprehend that what we are asking for is not in any way denting the exchequer in any which way. It's only a support. So what is holding them back is a very, I can't comprehend it, but I feel that we continue to push and we will get it. Airlines are opening up on Monday. And by the way, what Nakul said, that it's not social distancing, and we should never use that word, because man is not antisocial. What we are talking about is physical distance, or safe distance, as he called it. Now, in the airline, they are going to be three seats, and it's going to be a full load. So there's going to be, if it's a 200 seater, there are going to be 200 people. Why is it that the restaurants have to follow any such rules and regulations? Why do we have to have that distance where if you can be sitting in an aircraft for 4 hours with a full load of 200 people, how does that make it any safer than you coming into a restaurant and being able to get service from a boy who's perhaps wearing a mask? And then the other thing comes up that if there's a restaurant of 100 seater and we only got 50 people sitting there and all of them are wearing masks, how are we going to do the service with them?
Yeah.
You know, and it's all about, it's an industry where people serve people. We are people centric. Yeah. We cannot be robotic. So while I understand what Nakul is saying, that there is going to be a lot of that touchless element that is going to come in, but it's going to take away the very ethos of hospitality. We are people-centric. We have to have that smile on our face. We have to be able to give a comfort to the customer who comes in. So it's a very tight walk that we have to do. Yeah. Having said that, we do have to abide to all hygiene standards. All of us are doing it already. So we do need to keep that in mind. However, I think the government has to sort of loosen up all the do's and don'ts that they are talking about so that we can actually begin to get a little bit close to normal. I hope it does happen that way because, like I said, you know, we are a people-centric industry. It's all about service. It's all about that warmth. So I do hope that that comes back. But I think what is going to be good with this, and a lot of our panelists have spoken about it, we'll have cleaned up ourselves on several levels. Trimmed away the fat, we will have more multi-skilling, more multitasking, the definition of luxury will change, we will become more responsible, we will be more sustainable. So I think at the end of it, it's going to be actually a great learning experience for us, and we are going to come out better than what we were. So that element, I think we all need to take advantage of this time and try and see how best we can adapt to this particular situation. But at the end of it, we do want to have that smile, that warmth, and we do want to be able to look after people and make them feel happy and comfortable. It's not social distancing. We can never be socially distant. It's just that physical distancing, which will last for a while. It cannot last for a long time. It's impossible. We cannot take away the hug from each other. We can't. So a point will come when all of us will have gone through all of this and then come out as winners. So I vote for the human touch back again. In the first place, I think international travel is going to take a very long time to happen. We are going to be focusing on domestic tourism and therefore the international travel that we are looking for, where we may have a lack of an advantage, it's going to take a very long time. Ultimately, we will get back that smile. That's what we're all hoping for. And we are hoping that at the end of 2 years or a year and a half, we will get back to the Indian traditional hospitality. But there's something about the Indian hospitality which goes beyond that. There is an innate hospitality that exists in all of us, and that cannot be taken away. So I don't see us losing on any of that going forward.